Hell of a welcome home, ain't it, Rangers? Now, how do you feel about making up for not stopping this robot rodeo back in Los Angeles? I know you did, and I don't blame you. Can't expect a single team to stop an army. Just offering you a chance to get some of your own back. I bet you got a pretty good idea how it happened. But if you want to know the gory details, well, Matthias's choppers came out of the west like a swarm of hornets, dumped his synths and scorpatrons on our doorstep, and cracked us like a goddamn walnut. That's what happened. Now we're out here, and they're in there, with Matthias shouting every 5 minutes about how pretty soon he's gonna bring Cochise back to life. Didn't even get the chance to finish up the little going-away present we were planning on leaving for him. Yeah, Min was rigging up that Davy Crockett nuke we had in the museum with a couple other warheads we had in cold storage. Planned to set off the whole shebang once Matthias's army all got inside. But they overran our position and killed him before he could finish it. If we could get back into his workshop and set it off, that might be the surest way of wiping out those robot bastards for good. The Desert Rangers aren't the Citadel. We'll still be the same force for good no matter where we hang our hats. We can wipe out this robot cancer before it spreads to the rest of Arizona. I call that a bargain. Of course, if you can find another way to get the job done, I'm all for it. Don't know how that's possible, seeing as how he's here and Base Cochise is 100 miles north, and seeing as how we left the place a smoking wreck last time we paid a visit. But if he can do it, that would be a very bad thing. I already fought an endless army of killer robots once in my life. Don't really fancy doing it again. Personally, I say we stomp his ass ASAP, just to be on the safe side. Well, we sent word to our allies and pulled together a combined strike team to take back the Citadel. But we need a spearhead, an experienced squad who's faced these bastards before and lived to tell. Afraid you're the only team that fits the bill. Also, if you'll have me, I want to sign on with your team. You'll still be given the orders, but this Matthias character has made it personal, and I want a chance at taking his head. You okay with that? Thank you, Rangers. Ready when you are. Echo One, your recent progress merits a field promotion for one of your team. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well. Very good, Team Echo. Let's get those bastards.
Hey now, it's the recruits again. Vargas told me the Citadel had a fight on its hands, so I came to see if I could help out. The least I could do after everything you've done for Ag Center. I'm back in fighting shape thanks to you, so if there's anyone you need me to whoop, just let me know. Don't rub it in, kid. Now that I can look him in the eye and see what's coming, I can hold my own. Can I follow you in a battle?
We owe you big time, Rangers.
Hiya, Haas. Heard you were having a little robot problem, and since you helped us with ours, thought we'd help you with yours. Then lead the way, pal. We're right behind you. What do you say?
Welcome back. Storming the Citadel one last time, eh? Very good. Well, I was able to grab a couple things before the evacuation. I've outfitted the folks who showed up in response to our distress call. But everything else is all yours. Hope they help. Make good use of them. Blast those metal monsters back to California. Good luck. Anything else I can help with? Good luck.
Citadel will not fall to you again. You've already denied humanity its destined perfection once. I won't let you do it twice. 15 years ago, the Guardians and the Base Cochise AI created the first truth synthesis of man and machine. Erwin John Finster. He wasn't perfect, but he was a beginning. A triumph of science. A beacon for the future of humanity. And shot to pieces by a bunch of savages wearing tin stars. There was still hope. And that hope was me. The next iteration. With all the imperfections that had made Finster unstable. Correct. All that was left to do was install the final upgrade. The protocol that would allow me to link my mind with others of my kind and combine our intelligences so the walls will have always divided one human from another would finally be torn down. No one would ever be lonely again. We would all be one, and it would be wonderful. Sadly, that's where you came in, Ranger. From the very day I was to have become the first true exultant, you came with your guns and your grenades and murdered the Guardians, destroyed the base Cochise AI, and stole my golden future. But now, I am once again on the brink. The AI you thought you destroyed copied itself in Citadel mainframe, hidden right behind your pathetic human nose. And now, I am copying it directly into my brain. Once the download completes, the AI will grant me my transcendence. You and your allies will be granted your death, and Earth's golden future will finally begin. Humanity has had its chance, Ranger. It's the Exalted's turn now. Time for you to go. Thank you.
What else do you need? Very good, Team Echo. Let's get those bastards.
Hostiles detected in the Citadel. Seal the main doors. Alert.
Impossible. No one could fight through our army. Let me see that monitor. You made it back to Arizona? How? How do you keep winning? You should be dead. 100 times dead. Dugan should have killed you. The Scorpatrons should have killed you. My army should have killed you. You are like cockroaches. Why do you keep hounding me? The enemy of humanity? I am the savior of humanity. I'm the one taking them out of the Dark Ages, where murderous bullies like you have all the power. And who gave you the right to decide what is just and what is unjust? On whose authority? For instance, did you decide that the Guardians must die? You walk into every situation you come across like you're the policeman of the world. You just pronounce judgment on one side or the other, and then bang, dead people everywhere. Who made you the law? Who said you're the only ones that get to kill people without being called the bad guy? People have asked me for help, too. They've asked me to save them from pain, from death, from their oppressors. And I am doing my best to bring them a future where none of those things exist. So why are you mad at me? Because I committed a few murders in order to save the folks who asked my help? So did you. You've killed hundreds. Explain to me the difference. You're going in circles, Rangers. You say you kill bad people. Who decides which people are bad? The Rangers do. Who gave them the authority to make that decision? The good people? Who decides which people are good? The Rangers do. It's an endless loop. Admit it. You kill who you want to, just like I do. There is no difference between us. Ah, enough. I'm losing my patience with you. We can talk reasons all day, but in the end, you're just here to kill me. Ah, honesty at last. You hound me because I threaten your status as the Alpha Wolves of Arizona, just as you hound all others who defy you. At least you're honest enough to admit that has nothing to do with humanity, or morals, or civilization. Your gang hates my gang, and that's that. inXile download is complete. I will be immortal. I will have moved beyond your power. Atomic Command's savagery is almost over. The time of the exalted is upon us. In fact, now that I think of it, I'm glad you were here. It's fitting for you, who have sought to sabotage my inevitable godhood. Every step of the way should be the one to witness my ascension. It will be the last thing. The elevator. It will take you to me. But hurry, the download.